JoJo's Bizarre Adventure Stone Ocean, Episode 1 to 12 Review. Stone Ocean is a 5th season of JoJo's Bizarre Adventure and covers the 6th part of the original manga story written by Hirohiko Araki, thanks to the first season containing parts 1 and 2. For those unfamiliar, JoJo's is an odd series, it's not just because, as the title suggests, it can get quite bizarre, but also that it's split into parts, each set in new locations, time periods, and with the two central protagonists, along with a mostly new cast, since the 3rd part all the stories have featured stands, personifications of characters' powers that exist as a separate entity, serviceable only to other stand users. During the course of the series, so far some fans have more than lived up to the bizarre moniker that makes up part of the series titled with extremely imaginative powers, and even more imaginative ways for our lead characters to get out of them. Stone Ocean is set in 2011 at Green Dolphin Street Prison in Florida, and our lead protagonist is Jolene Cujo. Daughter of Part 3's protagonist, Jutara Cujo, she ends up in prison due to being involved in a hit and run with a car driven by her boyfriend, but it soon established that locking her away was actually the plan of a mastermind located at the prison in which they drove Jutara to him so he can use his time abilities to steal his memories and find out a key piece of information to be as fog as I can. Jutara intentionally sneaks a piece of stand-creating arrow that has been fixed at the series and Jolene gets stabbed by it, giving her stand powers, but the arrow pieces goes missing. And several other female inmates end up with stand powers. Then the man who is after the Cujo family also creates some stand users, and before you know it, we're in familiar territory as Jolene soon gathers together some allies and spends an episode or two episodes battling a new stand user and overcoming their often odd abilities. Jolene starts off quite timid and scared, but it doesn't take long for her to gain self-confidence, and soon she is adapting to the harsh nature of prison life. In the even harsher world of stand battles, she's a very fun character that's easy to root for, quite a tomboy but in a good way. Most of these 12 episodes take place in the female wing of the prison. Many nerdy and their cast are female, which is a refreshing change compared to the previous 5 parts and quite forward-thinking for something originally written in 2000 to 2003, especially given it's a shonen story, a subgenre packed to the brim with powerful male leads with female sidekicks or powerless love interest. Thanks to the manga series being so far yet, these adaptations have suffered to all of the perils of filler. Each manga chapter gets adapted with care and attention without overstaying their welcome. And I'm happy to report Stone Ocean also gets the same care. The series also keeps up debut production's top-class animation as well, especially during some of the fight sequences which often vary between suitable, weird, and unpleasantly gory. A battle against a stand user who can create a dome of total vacuum was especially well handled, as well as the rather odd finale sequence that it won't spoil here. I'll be seeing allies and stand user because it's usual with JoJo's Bizarre Adventure author. Author Hirohiko Araki has named characters and stands directly after bands, which is fine with the laws or copyright laws in Japan, but for us here in the West, causes issues. So if you watch subtitle, you hear the character referred to as Foo Fighters, but the subtitle would read FF, or the lead villain stand is called White Snake, but the subtitle read Pale Snake. Maybe Jolene's stand is called Stone Free, but the subtitles read Stone Ocean. I think this oddest case is a character named Weather Report, who has changed to Weather Forecast. Not only is a character named Weather Report weird, but I would thought you'd be able to get away with a character name after a regular feature of the news without drawing attention to the band of the same name, but there you go. The opening theme is Stone Ocean, but Ishigo will the ending theme continue the anime's streak of Western songs for the time period the part is set in. Apart from the first two parts, which are set in Victorian London in the late 1930s respectively, but have a distant dreamer to Duffy close out the episodes. Both the Japanese and English audio are available for all episodes, and from what I hear, the English dub isn't bad at all. So for something as over-the-top and weird as this, I find the Japanese voice cast do a better job screaming what, in the very amusing ways, personally. The first 12 episodes of JoJo's Bizarre Adventure Stone Ocean continues the anime streak of well-paced manga adaptations, with great animation and lack of worry about featuring some of the more well-bizarre or gory scenes featured in the original story. Jolene is a fun character to follow, quickly hardening due to her time being behind bars, and so standing up for herself with her now newfound powers, and is surrounded by an equally interesting cast. If JoJo's strange blend of action, humor, and how on earth would it get out of this weird stand powers? Cliffhangers and appeal in the past are sound good, no. You can go wrong with Stone Ocean, 9 over 10.